Hey guys, welcome to this week's Cobra Camp. And I think 2 weeks ago I did a pull-up 101 video with you guys. Well, this week is push-ups 101. And you might be wondering, oh my gosh, why is it short off? I'm not trying to show off or anything, I guarantee you. It's just what I'm going to show you today. I'm going to do some demonstrations and you kind of need to see my chest if it's going to work. So today, this video is push-ups 101. I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about push-ups in one video. Let's go. Okay, the first and most basic mistake persons make with push-ups is their hand position. Persons do push-ups in a T-form like this, and when you do push-ups in a T-form like this or even bench press, you're using your shoulder muscle and not your chest. And your shoulder muscle isn't meant to be pushing like this, it's meant to be pushing more upwards. So over time, doing push-ups like this and even bench press, you are going to damage your shoulder muscle. All push-up movements, your arms should be tucked inwards. And I want you guys to look at this, right? This position, I'm trying to use my chest. Look how much chest engagement I'm getting from this versus tucking them in. That's a huge difference. This position does not allow you to engage your chest muscle. It's not the right position to use your chest. This, however, you get a lot more chest engagement. So, mistake number one, push-ups. Your elbows should be tucked in. You should not be doing push-ups in a T. Okay? So, this does not work your chest. So that is mistake number one. You guys need to get that corrected. Okay, another mistake persons make with push-ups is their body position and range of motion. So I'm about to demonstrate three common problems with a push-up form, okay? The first one, your head being lower than your body. So this. When you're doing push-ups, your entire body should be following a single line. Head, butt, back, all in line. Your head, your waist, and your back all should go down together and come back up together. You shouldn't have your waist lower than your chest and doing this or this or this. Okay?
Okay, that's a bit much.
Along the same line. And that is how you should perform your push-ups. If you're doing these little things where your waist is lower or your neck is pointing downwards, over time, you're gonna cause damage to parts like your lower back or the base of your neck or your shoulders. So it's very important you make these tweaks and correct these major problems on your push-ups. All right, mistake number three. Using momentum. A lot of persons, when they're trying to train their chest with push-ups, they're like, oh, super fast, down, up, using a bunch of bunks. And guys, yeah, you might knock out 100 push-ups doing it like that. However, relying on momentum and not squeezing your muscle throughout the top and bottom part, the positive and negative part of the push-up, you're seriously just wasting a lot of time and effort. So I'm gonna show you what you're not supposed to do, then what you're supposed to do. Wow, so fast, so strong. This is not doing anything for your chest, guys. Your push-ups, you go down, contracting your chest, you squeeze coming up. Rule of thumb is at the bottom and top of the motion, you should maybe stop for like 0.2 seconds to cut the momentum. So you're not just bouncing with elasticity from your tendons, but instead squeezing your muscle. Okay guys, so that's something else you should correct with your push-ups if you're planning to make some gains on your chest, okay? Now guys, a lot of you who might have been making these mistakes over years and knocking out some really high numbers of push-ups, you're gonna notice when you make these changes, the amount of reps you're able to do is gonna drop drastically. And some of you might not even be able to carry out the push-up movement with the correct form. And that's okay, because at the end of the day, form is better than numbers. Why are you doing push-ups? What is the purpose of this exercise? It's to build strength in your chest. So it doesn't make sense you fool yourself saying I can do 50 of these when you're not really even using your chest. So guys, when you're doing your push-ups, make these corrections and perform the full range of motion. Otherwise, you're really wasting a lot of time and effort. Now, for those of you who notice when you make the changes, you can't carry out the movements, I'm now going to give you a series of progressions from easiest to more difficult in push-ups. Let's go. Number one, you can bend your knees. When you get used to this, you now go up into the horizontal alignment position. And when these get even easier, you can then raise the elevation, put your foot on an elevated area and your hands on a lower plane. So, feet up, hands down. And these are different stages you can and progressions you could use for your push-ups. And for persons who can't even do it with their knees bent and on the floor, what you can maybe do is bend your knees and then put your arms on somewhere elevated, and that will reduce the weight even more. So these are some things you can do to build your chest strength up slowly. I hope this video was helpful for you guys, and if it was, remember to like, share, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Push-ups 101.